Illinois Tollway Building for Success webinar series. If you have joined us previously, welcome back. If this is your first time tuning in to our weekly series, we're glad that you could set aside the time in your busy day to spend with us. Some function problems here, okay. I'd like to do some housekeeping items before we begin today's presentation. First, everyone will be muted. If you would like to submit questions, please use the chat box function and include your name and company's affiliation so we know who you are. If you are joining us by phone or via computer or laptop, the presentation will be recorded and posted on the Tollway's website afterwards. And finally, please take a moment to fill out the brief survey following the presentation. We appreciate your feedback and would love to hear how you learned about today's event and if you have suggestions for future topics. The Department of Diversity and Strategic Development is a driving force for increasing economic opportunities in diverse communities we serve. Through our various programs and initiatives, the Tollway takes an active role in providing access to economic opportunities for small, diverse, and veteran businesses and individuals in the heavy highway construction industry. Today, my department is heavily focused on increased training and education opportunities like today's webinar, working with internal departments to identify economic opportunities for diverse firms, recruiting new entrants, and supporting programs and initiatives for historically underserved individuals. Today's webinar series topic is the ABCs of the Small Business Initiative. Our guest presenter today is Marlene Vick, the General Manager of Diversity. With her, we also have as panelists representatives from the CPO, the B2G Now, Procurement, Compliance, Engineering, and Risk Management that will be available after the presentation for questions and answers as panelist discussions. We have over 95 people registered for the webinar, so there is a fair amount of interest on the topic. Now I will turn it over to Marlene.
Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you for attending today's webinar. I can go on the next page. So this is going to be in a question answer format. And what we'll have is our panelists will be available at the end of the presentation to answer any additional questions that you have. So the first one, what is the goal of the Small Business Initiative, SBI? The Illinois Tollway Small Business Initiative is an expansion of the state's small business program, which has been in place for years, and it is an initiative of the Chief Procurement Office. This program concentrates on tollway construction contracts and does not focus on any professional services, consulting opportunities, or goods and services opportunities at this time. What are the requirements to participate in the Tollway SBI? The good news is that every construction-related small business registered with the state is eligible. The Tollway's SBI follows guidelines established by the Chief Procurement Office, which defines a contract, a construction small business, as having gross revenues of $14 million or less annually. The Tollway has established a brief application process available at iltollwaydiversitysoftware.com. on the Tollway's Diversity Small Business Initiative webpage to affirm all eligible businesses are registered with the state's Chief Procurement Office. Prime bidders must be registered in the state's Small Business Set-Aside program to be responsive. A business must also be registered in the Tollway's SBI program within 5 days of notification of apparent low bidder status. Primes may only utilize small business contractors registered in the SBI. That's actually the last icon. Any subcontractors identified at the time of bid and not already registered will have 14 calendar days to become registered. The tollway will work with the prime to assist their firms in completing the SBI registration. These are some recent updates we've made to the program. We've streamlined the registration process. SBI is now all electronic, no more paper enrollments. JVs will complete a pre-assessment prior to applying to SBI. The NAICS codes that are required will provide detail by which you can conduct a search by NAICS code, and we'll see an example of that later on with B2G now. The IPG verification documentation is no longer required as part of the application process. The tollway will verify that the vendor met the requirements of being in the Small Business Set-Aside program. If I'm a registered small business with the state, why do I also have to enroll in the tollway SBI? We do have a requirement that SBI contracts will involve ROSIP, so we do want the SBI firms to be enrolled in the program. In addition to that requirement, the SBI gathers additional information on vendors, demographics, NAICS, and so forth. What registrations, certifications do I need to have to qualify for enrollment in the tollways SBI? Only the registration in the State of Illinois Small Business Set-Aside Program qualifies for the tollways SBI. Being certified as a DM or WBE may help your firm meet a goal on a project, but these certifications do not replace the Small Business Set-Aside Program registration. You'll know that you are indeed in the Small Business Set-Aside Program registration if you go to the IPG webpage, and when you pull up your name, if you're in there, you'll see where the highlighted area, it'll say yes under Small Business Set-Aside Program Registered. There are many vendors in there that do not have a yes. It just says no, and it's not a problem. It doesn't mean you don't qualify, but you do need to apply to have that designation to be identified as such. Forms A through C will only give you a vendor number, an IPG number, where it says system vendor number. Forms A through I will give you they'll be reviewed for certification with the Small Business Set-Aside Program. SBI's bid submission common mistakes. I'm submitting a bid for an SBI contract. Is there anything I should pay particular attention to in my submittal? First, please make sure you use the construction bid checklist. This list contains all of the required documents and signatures that will help you be responsive. This is a three-page list, and it should have all of the a description of everything that you need. Some additional omissions are disclosures not being submitted, Forms A or Forms B. That particular requirement is an up or down. Either you have it or you don't, and if you don't have it, you are automatically deemed non-responsive. One of the things that they will look at. The DBE 2026, the VOSB 2026, and EEO 1256 must be completed. The bid bond must be presented with seals and required signatures. The pay items, complete all P pages with unit price and unit totals. This is very important. Some other common mistakes include not being registered as a small business set aside or SBI. If there is a pre-qual that you are not pre-qualed by IDOT or CDB, so please look in the contract documents to see if that is required. And late submittals. Late submittals are not considered. 1 minute late is the same as being an hour late. We want you to be successful, so please look at the bid checklist when you are turning in your submission. Waiver process. If a prime vendor cannot identify a subcontractor registered with the SBI to perform a scope of work, is there a waiver process? Yes, there is a waiver request process. In section 8.6, small business exception procedures, vendors will find instructions on how to request a small business exception and the documented efforts to be included. A prime contractor's request for a small business exception must show the prime took all necessary and reasonable steps to subcontract with small businesses. Such steps may include soliciting small businesses and following up on inquiries to determine interest, and please make sure you document, providing businesses with plans, specs, and requirements in a timely manner, and please make sure you document this. Working with association groups, chambers of commerce, and so forth. I will let everyone know that the Tollway Technical Assistance Program is an additional resource that can assist both larger and smaller primes in identifying subs or even other JV partners. This goes along with similar good faith efforts. Soon we will have a form that will show you, but in the meantime, they are detailed in 8.6. For SBI joint ventures, can a contractor establish a joint venture, JV, with a non-SBI vendor? Short answer is no. Each JV partner must be registered and enrolled in the Tollway SBI, and the combined gross annual revenues of all the partners cannot exceed the state's $14 million threshold. Also, as mentioned previously, JVs must complete a pre-assessment form prior to applying for the SBI application. Finding SBI contractors. We have Tanya Blakely of B2G Now here to walk us through how to conduct a search.
And hi, welcome everybody. I'm Tanya Blakely. I'm the project manager for this implementation. Is there a way I can get the screen? Oh, I am now the presenter, so give me 1 second and let me share my screen. So hopefully you guys can now see the IL Tollway screen. And to do a search, well, first to get to the URL, if you guys need to, to register for the SBI, you will type in your URL browser, which would be iltollway.diversitysoftware.com, and we'll put that in the chat box for you. But that is going to be the registration URL of how that's going to get you to this program page. Simple enough to do a search of the Vick directory. You are just, once you get to the portal, you're just going to click on search vendor directory. You have the ability to search by firm's name, or you can search by a business description, and you can also search by commodity codes. So if you're looking for a vendor who is performing work in concrete, I can simply just type in the words concrete, or I can identify that NAICS code through a browsing code list to find those vendors associated with that code set. So by simply clicking that, I can see there's concrete here. I did a basic search, and I want to look for individuals that do any type of poured concrete. Oops, comes out of that, and then that's it. So by me identifying poured concrete, I could definitely do that search here, any lower codes that I may want to attribute to it. And simple enough, you click you're not a robot, because, for CAPTCHA laws and things like that, and I want to search. And as you can see, it brought up businesses that have that in their description or in their NAICS code. So here we see Bill Welding, we have Aretha Construction, and it provided us with a list here. On the right-hand side, you would just click on the certification or the registration, and it will bring you up to the contact information related to that business. And as you can see here, there is that poured concrete foundation of that NAICS code that I searched for. So the searching capabilities are very simple and quick. You also have the ability to search by NIGP codes as well. But again, it's a very easy thing to toggle through. You can even download the search results. So then that way, if you want to take it into an Excel, you have that ability. And just to kind of reiterate how to apply for the renew registration is when you do come onto the portal and you have your, the state of Illinois registration, you've already gone through that process and you want to basically start a new application or new registration, it will ask you a couple things to create an account if you don't already have one or an account lookup. And from here, you're going to be able to log in if you do have a vendor profile, and then that will direct you to the actual registration. All right. That's all I have, folks. I didn't know if you want me to go further into the registration, but it is a very, very simplistic registration for all of you guys to complete.
Great, Tanya, thank you. For SBI registration status, who do I contact if I applied for registration in the SBI program and have not heard back? Siobhan Moore is the main point of contact for application issues, but also be aware that you can call the any one of us on Tollway staff to ask general questions. And assistance with the SBI process. What if I need help completing the registration process with the state of Illinois, with the state or the tollway? The Tollway Technical Assistance Program has 5 providers that are here to assist you with not only registration, but with putting your bid packages together, identifying subcontractors, all of that. The information can be found on the Tollway website on the diversity page under programs. And the 5 providers are Construction Business Development Center, CBDC, at Prairie State College, Chicago Minority Supplier Development Center, CMSDC, in Chicago, Griggs Mitchell Alma Construction Group, GMA, they're in Rockford and Chicago, Inner City Underwriting, Chicago, and Illinois Hispanic Chamber of Commerce in Chicago. And with that, I think we go on to the next phase.
That's right. Thank you so much, Marlene and Tanya, for a great presentation. At this point, I want to go ahead and open up for question and answer. For anyone in the audience, please feel free to enter your questions in the Q&A and chat function. We do have panelists representation from the Diversity Department, Chief Procurement Office. We've got Andrew Shackelford and Eleanor Kirkero. Engineering, Pete Fornsler, Risk Management, Paula Blonsky, Procurement Compliance, we've got Grace Perez, Saini, and Shelley, Procurement Contract Services, Grace Gomez, and Donna Williams, and B2G Now, Tanya Blakely. So if you guys have any questions at this time, please go ahead and enter them in the chat function, and we can go ahead and address those. All right, so we're starting to get some questions. First of all, I want to reiterate that these slides will be available and posted to the website along with the recording of this webinar. You can find it on the Diversity Webinar Series page on the Tollway's website. I'll also put the link to the B2G Now portal in the chat function so that in the case you have any questions or you want to see if you can apply or navigate the website, it's available to you. So for anyone who wants to know if the slides will be distributed, they will be on the website. All right, I have a small business initiative, but when I search NAICS codes, I don't show up.
You would have to look at your registration to ensure that the NAICS code is added correctly. If you do find that a NAICS code is missing from your registration, please notify the tollway staff, and then they can go ahead and make those updates. I know that we were still going through and making the NAICS codes updates where we only had the NIGP. So please contact the staff member to go ahead and make those additions for your record. And you can always go in and do a no change. So if there's a, if you wanted to go in and update a code, just you can go through the system and do that as well. If you already have an existing registration and you just want to report a change, you have that ability to do that through the system as well.
Thank you, Tanya. I thought I saw in question 5 that we had to have capital development or IDOT pre-qualification. Do you need that for small business initiative contracts?
That is only if it is in the contract. For the most part, SBI contracts, we try not to have that. But if it is required and it's an SBI, we would ask that that would be part of what you have to do. But that's on a contract by contract basis.
Thank you, Marlene. Will there ever be any non-construction contracts available in the future for small business initiative?
At this time, we do not foresee that, but never say never.
How long does it normally take to receive notification of small business application approval?
I'm sorry, it's Siobhan. It's usually 5 days after we've received all the information needed to process the application. So it's 3 to 5 days.
Thanks, Siobhan.
And just to kind of clarify, if you're needing to register with small business set aside program 2 before then, the response time to have your registration vetted is around 7 days.
Thank you, Andrew. Can the entire small business initiative directory be printed out?
Yes, yes, it can. This is Tanya. If you go into a search, you don't have to do any specific search on the bottom. On the bottom of the searching, once you click on search vendors, you can download the entire directory. It will ask you to put in just a case-sensitive sequence of numbers, just so that it because we try to prevent any spam and scammers trying to download that directory. So that's how we protect it. But yes, you sure can.
Thank you, Tanya. I've got a couple more questions coming in here. What happens if I don't submit completed P pages?
Hi, this is Grace from Contract Services. If the P pages are incomplete, it's possible that the bid will not be accepted and therefore probably lead to a non-responsive.
Thank you, Grace. Under the section of questions, number 16, it states business categories. Is there a reason why engineering is missing?
Right now, the SBI is focusing on construction contracts. If we do expand our SBI to include engineering contracts, we would include that business category as well.
Thank you, Kristen. What items will deem me non-responsive for a small business initiative contract?
This is Grace again from Contract Services.
There are several things that can cause a bid to be non-responsive. The information is listed in volume one. It's really important to go over the checklist because that checklist does tell you about the Forms A, Forms B that's required, if there's an applicable Form 2026. So volume one really has a lot of information and does talk about what would be non-responsive. And also the A1 page, which is in volume one, talks about, you know, 5% of the bid has to be submitted, you know, for the bid bond. So there could be various reasons that can cause a bid to be non-responsive. I hope that answers the question. I don't know if you want me to elaborate because there could be a lot, I mean, more information.
Thank you, Grace. What happens if I don't have a corporate seal for bid bonds?
We do check all the bids that come in, all the bid bonds. We're checking to make sure that, you know, the contract number's on there, that the bid bond is 5% of the bid. And we're making sure that there's a witness that signs off on it, that the vendor's signing off on it, there's a corporate seal. We have noticed a few bids coming in lacking that information. Those bids were not considered non-responsive because we did call the bid company, the surety, and to verify the authenticity of this bond. But it's really important to make sure that when the bid bond is submitted, that everything is everything signed, and if there's a seal, if you have a corporate seal, to use a corporate seal. It definitely will not make the process a little smoother for us and for you as well, and make sure there's no questions that that come up if things are missing.
Thank you, Grace. As a general contractor, can you use a non-SBI if no SBI sub is responsive? If so, is there any special documentation needed?
As mentioned in the presentation, there is the small business exceptions, SBE. Please remember that is a request, and you need to have documentation that you not only reached out and had good faith efforts, and there's a list in section 8.6 of the special provisions, but also that you document all of that. Your reaching out does not constitute good faith efforts. You're reaching out, you're following up, talking to people, and documenting each step of the way can be submitted and considered.
Okay, thank you, Marlene. I've got one more question. This is related to the renewal process. How will I know when I have to renew my application for SBI? Do I get a notification, or is it something that I have to be ensure I keep track of?
This is Siobhan again. You will receive a notification before your due date, before it expires. So there is a notification sent to your via email. And please, vendors, check your spam or junk mail, because sometimes the emails will go into those.
All right. It looks like I don't have any other questions. That all the questions have been answered. So at this time, does anyone in the panelists want to add anything? Or have any other comments before we conclude the webinar?
This is Andrew. I'll put the number for the IPG help desk into the chat in case anybody needs it when they're completing that registration. If they need to become a registered small business, they can go ahead and call that number if they have any questions. Also, I'll be available to if anybody has questions as well. So I'll put that contact information in the chat.
Thanks, Andrew. I'm also adding the chat box in the chat box to everyone, the link to B2G, if anyone has interest in clicking around on that website. So with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and put my slides up again and finish off the presentation. All right, for the most up-to-date information on upcoming contracting opportunities, please visit the Tollway's website at illinoistollway.com, which is the ultimate resource for doing business with the Tollway. Under the Doing Business tab, you'll find information on the diversity programs and outreach, construction bid letting schedule, professional service bulletin look-ahead schedules, information on the Tollway's buying plan, and anything on how to get certified and pre-qualified, resources including online plan room and videos on how to submit Tollway work. So we want to thank everybody for attending today. I want to thank all the panelists for participating and being here to answer questions. Hopefully everyone can join us next week. We will be having another webinar on Monday the 26th, and it will be on professional services partnering for growth. Thanks and have a great evening.